Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 7 in our series, statelesscode.com WordPress. So I'm still working on getting the basic layout styling working. So I found this article, Sage theme sidebars, how to set sidebars up properly in Sage. I mean, this is from 2016, so it's obviously not the most current way to do things in Sage, but at least gave me the ideas on where to look. So this register sidebar function, you can see they've gotten it cleaner with refactoring this out to a variable, but this register sidebar primary and register sidebar footer. So it looks like that's occurring, and then it just adds the config to it. So if I now go and find my code, let me go back to the site here. So we go to the elements, there should be in our body app, and then we've got a side class sidebar and a footer. This might actually be a footer within the so we've got that side class sidebar. Let's take a look at our class this widget. Have that section there. Section class widget. So within that sidebar and within that footer. So we've got that class sidebar. So let's take a look at the resources here, views, sidebar dot blade is in layouts. So we've got our ID and then class equals sidebar. This will give us class equals parcels footer. So I should be able to in my styles here, or we've imported Tailwind. Let me see if I can just, for the sake of playing around here, I'm going to try to use the sidebar. I'm going to try to use the apply directive here to see if I can at least get the these two things so that I can see them more readily in the layout. So I'll pause and do that. So I've got this apply directive, so add apply, and then you just essentially put your classes with the spaces there, and I'll do the same thing. So this is going to be hideous right now, but it will at least hopefully just help me identify what's going on here. I've got some see if that works or if I need to I probably need to rebuild it, but we'll find out. Yeah, the backgrounds don't seem to have changed anywhere. So let me footer. So let me try compiling it. All right, so we've compiled. Let's see if that changes anything for our... Oh, so there's our sidebar. And then we've got more stuff here. Spec element. So this is archives within the footer. Class content info. So that's within the sidebar. I don't know if I've got the footer. So I've got the content info here in a footer tag. That's still in our layout. Include partials.footer. Sidebar dash footer, and it does have that content info. So maybe I need in my layout taking a look at commits recently to Sage, and I'm just gonna pull in some of the changes that occurred recently. See if any of them, the sponsors, we're gonna overwrite the let's take a look at this. That is fairly significant. I might just add that as a remote and cherry pick those commits. So we've got Sage fetched here, and I should be able to, let me take a look at my thing. Should be able to cherry pick those two commits. Thank you. probably need to rerun my initial installation here. Rebuild yarn. Refreshed my page here. Nothing breaking that I can tell. So let's see if we can get. So this is the header. In the footer, it's weird that the all that stuff about I want to see if there's class equals footer anywhere in this source. Into a temporary file. No results. So we go to our config here. Registering sidebars. So we register the footer, an ID sidebar footer. And it would have a class equal to footer somewhere in there. Sidebar primary in my let's go back to the source. Right, so we have not registered. Sidebar primary isn't there. So we get to the end here. We got that footer section, and then that's the end of the HTML. But again, this is just archives and stuff, which is kind of almost another like it's supposed to be the footer of the sidebar rather than a true page footer. going to make that move, so hopefully I won't break everything by doing this. So we'll put this in the header, in the sidebar partial. Where's my sidebar partial? So right now this is going to duplicate, I imagine, but there'll be, the archives will be in pink and then in white, which is fine. Now we want what that white was. Here we're going to get our This is just a dynamic sidebar footer. I think I'm just going to call this site footer. I'll change our styles, if I can find them. Here we go, to use site footer. We will throw in that partial, just a good old just so we can get an idea where the box is. Oh, it's going to be there, but it's going to be, so we haven't recompiled yet. I'll do that. Run yarn build. Got it compiled successfully. Now I should see that seafoam colored footer. So we've got that. Now we can look toward. So I'm going to see if I can make this when we go back to our page. Content. So we've got content page, single, page dot blade. It's in the layout that I have. See here, pros. There we go. So we've got pros there. So we're going to stick with using this apply syntax here. call this main layout content. We will go back to our styles. Makes anything bigger or better. Pause and recompile again. Ooh, and I have a compilation error. So this would be an example of why it's good to put these in the apply directives, because it will fail to compile rather than just being a useless class. So let's try to recompile. And we still have an error. Okay, so main needs to be back in. That is not a Tailwind class. But it might be significant for. In recompile, we're back to a successful compilation. Let's see. So we've got it wider now on the large screens. Go back smaller, still working there. By all right, so we've got the ideas of where these things are, we'll do a better job. Okay, there's our footer. So it is showing up in mobile. So we've at least got the E on the I chart here. And I will stop this video and pick up in the next one to try to get a responsive flex box working. So we have the sidebar here, probably at least for large and XL. And then once we get to down to mobile, we would want something more like this. But we'll get going on that in the next video. We'll commit our progress that we have so far. One last thing. So when I go to the dashboard here, so when it says appearance themes, this theme is still showing as Sage starter theme. So let me see if I can find where that is in the looks like style CSS, the items there. So I'll pause, update this real quick. All right, so I've got my replacement there. I'll try compiling that and see if that updates the name of the theme on WordPress. All right, so compiled successfully. Let's see. There, so changing that in the CSS comments does replace the name. So we'll stop there. We'll commit. Do it overall diff cached. So got our applies. We've changed our footer. We'll now commit. Write our message. I've got my commit message. I'm going to have to do a commit amend because I forgot to save one of the files here. So we're gonna close saved. We just got the untitled HTML page source there. And if we go back, the header push and see you in the next episode.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.